name's Alan Helland. I run my own farm, Blue Fox Farm, which has got a new planting on it of 2.5 acres. And then for River Hills Harvest and MDC, I take care of this 9-acre field. I've been in charge of it for 3 years, and this is probably the year we've got it looking the best in the 3 years I've taken care of it. Had a little weed control issues in it, which, when we talk about the problems for elderberry, that is one, I guess, any perennial orchard you have that trouble with. So our production practices, a typical year, by the second year under good production, you'd start to get a yield. Third year is probably getting up to a normal yield. Our standard practice has been to, in the winter, once the orchard is mature, we cut to the ground. So some farmers do that, you know, with a tractor or a brush hog. We actually do it with a still weed eater out at this place because elderberry is kind of a shallow rooted plant. So kind of, we'll cut down, finishing up in, you know, start in January, cut this to the ground, and then it's fruit and flower on first year stock. So we're kind of running them like Prima Cane raspberries or blackberries. There's, you know, weed control and fertilizer, irrigation for the course of the season. And then we're at the end of the flowering time. Probably the middle of August, our first variety on the far end ranch, by the middle of August, thereabouts, we'll start. The fruit will be ripe. Usually I have about a week and a half to two of harvesting out of that variety. Right at the end, the middle variety, Bob Gordon on this field, will start to ripen, and the third variety, Adams, is more indeterminate, and it'll be kind of a longer time period, starting sometime Dream Bob Gordon and running a little longer. That's really handy so that you don't have all 9 acres of your fruit ripe all at once. Some of the production practices that are a concern is you're harvesting in August and the end of September. You've got a highly perishable fruit that needs to get cool quick, needs to be processed quickly. That's one of the things that limits the distance of farmers that can have us do the destemming. So the process would be we harvest early, start as early as we can, try and be done harvesting at the very latest by 11 or noon on the warm days. Cooler days, you can take that little back. We go back to Terry Durham's place where we have the processing place, and we have mechanized the destemming process. We have a machine that we can probably do, I wish I had a better number for you, but at least 600 or 700, maybe 900 pounds an hour. Any other way of doing that, there are hand baskets, you can freeze. There are other ways to doing it on a homestead scale, but this is far more efficient. So the production practice for that is then we're destemming and then we're sterilizing according to FDA standards. The FDA checks with us really carefully. It's basically a light bleach solution that we're dipping in. And then we're freezing in 25-pound buckets that then those are kept deep frozen and eventually moved down to our processing plant. Better deer fencing around my place. Deer are, if I didn't mention this on camera, deer are really bad pests. I mean, once a planting like this is mature, it's not a noticeable loss, but particularly when you're planting them, they can just take out a planting in no time, and they always cost us some. There's some people that I've spoken with feel like the birds do a fair bit of damage. That feels a little nominal to me on the fields I take care of, but I can see how, you know, different area that may be more of a challenge. My yield specifically in this is marketed through River Hills. So River Hills is our basic product is juice, and juice has at least a couple documented health benefits, antiviral and anti-inflammatory. We have evidence for. It's a little unfortunate that there are a whole lot of much greater claims of health benefits, probably due to the anti-inflammatory stuff. A lot of people are keyed into that, but it's one of the things that we deal with is we really only can say it's an anti-inflammatory, it's an antiviral. But you do hear a lot of really fantastic claims from customers about the benefits of it, but that's something we actually try and tamp down because we don't know for sure, and you don't want people taking this for more serious conditions without any scientific backing. River Hills markets wholesale a lot of the Missouri small health food stores, kind of the local ones. And then the other part is we shut down Amazon when we had too much demand, but we're doing online on Amazon and then online through our own website. So that's small amounts and, you know, relatively large amounts to individuals through the website. We have just started messing with the flowers, just a couple harvests, and we do have one product now that we're bottling, which is an elderflower cordial. Again, elderflower does not have any evidence of medicinal benefits. It's possible, particularly from people looking at the European one, but we don't know that or market it that way. Secondary processing is almost all of our market. In the past, we sold berries wholesale to people, and we do have a very few small ice cream producer and a very few other people we sell a limited amount to, but we need all of them to do our secondary processing into juice and the other products, so we don't really sell wholesale anymore. I'm sorry, we don't sell berries wholesale. We do sell the products wholesale. You know, a 3 to 4 acre orchard can make somebody, you know, a decent chunk of income. And it's my real hope that it stays that way, that this is a specialty crop that somebody can do on a limited acreage and have it be profitable for small-scale farmers. That's my hope. I think, as with so many crops, eventually it will be mechanized and become a larger scale if the demand keeps growing. But I think there's a wide window here where it will be a profitable crop for small acreage, and that's my hope. There's a huge demand. I mean, we have people, we sell cuttings and plants to people all over the country who are trying to do this, you know, way outside of our selling range. And they seem to either be developing their own products. A lot of people develop a small scale product for their regional area or their farmer's market, or they're selling into larger systems, making other products. So I think there's a lot of potential for it to become a valuable small fruit crop. One of the statistics that's interesting was elderberry ended up being the largest small fruit crop in Missouri. Yet that surprised all of us last year when Patrick Byers presented that to us. And we're like, what? That seems unlikely. But yeah, so we are the largest small fruit crop in Missouri and hope to keep that up. So if you're interested in being an elderberry farmer or being a producer for us, please contact River Hills Harvest. Our website online, riverhillsharvest.com, is the place to get a hold of us. Send us an email and we'll get back to you. Thanks.